You've seen some changes over the last 50 years. You had a whole lot of good boxers through your hands. You put a whole lot of good boys through the ring, and that suited them a good stealth all their days, PJ.
Well, Cormac, I've seen massive changes apart from the boxing, from the development here in the club itself. And if you look at the wall down there, you will see that we had 8 official openings in that 50-year period, since 1969. Mm-hmm. And one of them being the extension of the club, it was opened in 1979, and that included our own boxing gym here. And that made a huge difference. Like, we started in 66, it was decided at a meeting of the boys' club up in the shed at the back of Jap Hegarty's, that we should explore the possibility of a boxing club. That was due to the fact that Paddy Cutliffe and Mickey Gill were boxing in the Derry and District Championships in Derry. So it was decided that we should explore it further. And at the time, Andy McGlinchey was chairman, George Butler was on the committee, and I had a care. So the three of us decided that we would head for Derry to see what we could do. So we got to St. Columb's Hall, where the boxing was in progress, and we met Marcus Flaherty, who was actually sitting here tonight, and he pointed out the Derry officials to us. So we had a word with them anyhow and told them what we're up about and all the rest of it, and they says, well, right, we'll explore the whole thing in January of 1967. So, boys, you could say the rest is history. Mm-hmm. But in between times, there's a lot of things have happened, a lot of things have gone on. We started from very, very humble beginnings up in the shed at the back of Japs. What was unique about that, we had a ring and a shower in the corner, so you could have two fella sparring and one fella having a shower and some fella throwing soap under your feet. But there was a huge interest, an absolutely huge interest in boxing at the time, because there was little else in the town.
Well, Cormac, my earliest memory, standing beside this man here now, Mickey Doherty, as his well-known Mickey Gill, was on an old bike and heading down to the back of the drift inn, the two of us in the one bike, parking it with poor old hobnail boots on us, and then heading up to run up the White Strand, mm-hmm. to get ourselves kind of what we call fit. We hadn't a clue. Mm-hmm. But that all started down, as Mickey says, a wee while ago at the back of Jap Hegarty's, as we called it, in the old club. And I would give credit to men like Andy McGlinchey, George Butler, a few other members, Mickey Hooton, Hugh Henderson, Stanley Morrow. Mm-hmm. And they had the vision to see that there was something more than football needed for the young fellas to become involved in. Mm-hmm. So some of them came up with the idea of boxing. And that started the story off. Mm-hmm. So we were taking, me and Mickey here early on, there was nobody else involved at the time, and we were taking in, if my memory serves me right, to St. Eugene's in Derry. And we hadn't a clue. Well, Mickey would have had maybe a wee bit more than me, because his daddy was a professional boxer in his day before that, but I certainly hadn't a clue. And we were down in the bottom of St. Columb's Hall with old gas heaters that you reached up and pulled with a handle from the light to put them on and put them off. And we met a man called Patsy Heffern. And another man called George McCann later on, and boys like that, and old Willie McCann, his father. And that's where we started to pick up our first wee rudiments of what boxing was about. Mm-hmm. And Eugene's at that time had some good boxers. They had Neely McLaughlin, who went on, I think, to be an all-Irish flyweight champion.
That's right.
And he might have even competed in the Olympics or Europeans, some one of the two. They were good boxers now. They had a few very good boxers at that time. Of course, we weren't in that caliber. We were just the country boys up from Buncrana to put on the 16-ounce gloves and start to learn what it was all about.
I'd say you could hold your own right enough, the same boys.
Well, I never regarded myself as a fighting man at all in any sense like that, but the boxing, I think, you know, it attracted me because it gave me a good feeling of maybe feeling that you were good about yourself and that you could stand up for yourself or whatever, or just feel good about yourself. But it wasn't for the sake of wanting to hit anybody. Mm-hmm. It was just that discipline of learning to train and feel good about yourself as a young fella. And there was very little in Buncrana at that time except for football. And there's great history of football here in the town, which I had no interest in. Mm-hmm. Other Cutliffs had, but I hadn't.
What was your memories, Mickey, here at Buncrana Boxing Club, your when you joined the club and your first fight, and any titles that you won?
It seems a long time now, Cormac. I was chatting to Paddy earlier. Paddy seems to have a better memory than me now. I don't think he must have got hit as often as I did. He can remember further back than me, but as he mentioned where it all started, he mentioned earlier about the back of Maggie Rose, as we called it.
Mm-hmm. That's right.
And I come down here, I think I was about 16 years of age at the time. And loved every minute of it, you know. Look around here now, there's some changes from the first time we moved down here, mind you. But I say this 55 years ago, mm-hmm. believe it or not, you know. And I say there were great times. You know, I started boxing at 16 and the last fight was 32. Mm-hmm. I was here for 3 or 4 years and then father started a boxing club out in Westbrook, you know, so we moved out there then. But before that, this sort of all started, you know, great memories from the boys that trained us and trained along with Jimmy Quinn and Sonny Quinn, Danny McNutt. The trainers, Fonsi Center, was great help, you know. Oh, it was a great time for Fonsi. God rest him, I say, it was a great help. Showing us what he do and all.
Oh, right, definitely was. And not to forget your father. I remember your daddy coming in and teaching us in the old club upstairs, teaching us to skip. I remember that well, taking the rope and showing us how to skip.
I say they were great times, you know.
Fonsi enjoyed his time here. It was a great time for young boys here boxing too. He put a lot of time into it, to the boxing here in his time.
Fonsi was a remarkable man, you know. He was a gentleman, as everybody knows in the town. But I knew Fonsi since he was a gentleman, you know. But Fonsi just wanted to make you better, you know what I mean? And I think he had a bit of experience himself at the boxing.
Oh, well, he had been a professional himself. But
I think he was telling me his family didn't allow him to box.
Didn't allow him, that's right.
And he said to sneak away to box. He used to tell those stories, you know. But
he boxed under a pseudonym of a false name. And because the father didn't want to hear about it.
He was a complete gentleman, you know, and anything he'd say, he tried to better, you know. So great memories of Fonsi, you know, and Jimmy Cunn as well.
Mm-hmm. They were all tough boys in their day too, so.
They were tough boys. They were only starting off. We get. They were great times.
You were there at the very beginning. Did you fight in the first bill in the plaza? I think you did, or if you didn't, you fought in the second one.
Fought in the second one.
And we had down in the old boys club at the back.
Pack of Japs.
That was some place.
Brendan.
Brendan, you haven't been around here for a while.
No. Have not, PJ. I was lost tonight when I came in there. Really lost.
Yourself at times.
Didn't know where I was.
It's some development.
Brendan, just a part of there, not more involved in it, no.
Well, it comes and goes, and that's the way it is. It's the end of the season, and we're having as many, like, naturally, the football evenings are getting longer and all the rest of it. Tell me, what was your highlight?
Fighting Michael Sweeney in Ballyliffin.
That was a brave one, wasn't it? Mm. Sweeney was a good boy.
Sweeney was good, then.
Yeah?
Mm. But I would say the best night I was here was the night I fought your man from Eden Derry. Mind, he went to the finals of the All-Ireland. I stopped him in the second round.
Aye, certainly.
With the boxer of the night.
The place was full that day.
That was brilliant. That was a great night for me.
It was a brilliant night for you. So you'll never forget that one.
Never forget that one.
But you know, you put a lot into it.
I enjoyed it, PJ. I enjoyed the training.
Yeah.
No, both with Mickey and then Martin Coleman used to come down nights and we'd.
Yeah.
Trained away and Jackie Henderson, mine. Jackie.
Jackie Bobby. Had a lethal punch if he got you standing.
Aye, he was strong.
Well, we're just joined here by Bobby McMenamin. Bobby, no wonder we said you had a go at it and you found out that we were too pretty for it, so we went to do other things.
That's right, I moved on from it. I
moved on.
And we spent a good few years, didn't we?
We did.
65 to 1978.
It was a brave span, I think.
It was.
The two of us and
we're some of the best boxers that were on it at the time.
We produced them, we differently produced them, you know, differently.
That's
did.
Right. You had Kieran McDade and you had Patrick Grant and you had Eamon Fullerton.
That's right.
John Grant up on the pub up there and
that's right.
Who else had I got? Stephen Field.
We had a whole lot
We were able to one side of the ball one time.
Oh, well, I remember one night we had a bill out here and we had 16 on the bill. And
that's
we had
right.
eight that didn't get on at
that's
all.
Right. That's right.
Now, you'll probably remember the same night.
That's right.
Eamon Fullerton wasn't on to box. Eamon Fullerton, did he box McGuigan? No. Stephen Deary boxed McGuigan.
We took Stephen Deary up to the Working Man's Club, as he called it in Belfast. What do you call the club in Belfast?
The
Dockers Club Belfast. And Stephen Deary fought Barry McGuigan.
That's right.
He beat him in the first round.
Yeah.
And he lost heart in the second round. I always say this day, if he'd have stood with him, he'd have beat him.
He would. I definitely had him on the run that night, But we were everywhere. Where weren't we?
And know who we had in one day? One time was a juvenile, one of the Logans.
Yeah.
He was all on the football at the time, but he wasn't on the boxing.
He'd
done well until his arms started falling down.
So a lot of people came on board that time, and we got things together with the Derry boys, and in the April of that year we had a tournament in the Plaza. Massive turnout. One of the outcomes of that was John Fair. John Fair was the man that really put Buncrana boxing, got it on the road. And it wasn't from his boxing skills, it was some other skills that he had. And some fellow would say he would be better used to a cap and a bullock than he would at boxing. But it worked and it was great. And we had a lot of good fellows at that time that were bigger lads. In the early 1970s, we started on the juveniles. Big Jim Connolly and myself and Bobby McMenamin came on board and we got the juveniles going that time. We got a great run out of those guys and your brother being one of them. And we went from there, from strength to strength over the years. It was about 20, 25 years. We could field a full side of our own, no bother at all. It seems with 16 bouts on a bill and 8 more that couldn't get on that night and they weren't happy. But it was a great opportunity for young fellas. There was a lot of them went on that did well. Your brother Hughie Ginn won a national title. And there was the amount of young people that went through, I was trying to count up roughly, multiply, and we put about 1,500 to 2,000 young fellas through over that period of time. And I suppose it kept a lot of us right as well. There's many things I got out of it, many things I put into it. Uh-huh. But the people that I met, the fun that we had and the crack that we had, and God rest Big Jim Connolly and myself, it was a laugh a minute, and there was a whole thing, a lot of things came off that there. The word brother was one of the things that I have had to explain a few times in the last few days. How did that happen? And it happened because I used to meet Jim at the news and we'd come down to the club at about 4 o'clock and we'd work away with the young fellas down here. And one day we're coming down the street together and Bill Deneau was standing at the door and he was looking up the street and he says, brothers in arms. Mm-hmm. So Jim and myself started to call each other brother, and that's where that originated from. And Jim made a great meal of that one. Mm-hmm. But Cormac, I could go on for a long time on this here, but things have changed and they're changing. And we used to have a lot of big fellas that would come in, we'd say, September, October, and they'd come in to train, and halfway through they'd want to fight, and we'd get a show out of them, and they'd come on board, and we'd have a couple of good tournaments out of it. Those guys are gone. And, you know, over the last few weeks, I've been putting the book together, and I've been going back over press cuttings and stuff that I've had, and it's been an emotional journey, that part of it. Very emotional. You know, the amount of people that are dead and gone, good friends of mine. The amount of young people that are still about that are nearly as old as myself and have maybe less hair than I have. The fun that we had and the crack that we had and the places we went and they were a credit. The one thing, one of the reasons I probably stuck with them was they were brilliant young people to work with and we earned our respect. We didn't get it, we earned it. And we lived up to it and we were known far and wide, especially throughout Ulster. Any show that was worth having in those days, like PJ would get the call, and we often got the call in the morning at the night before, maybe at 11 o'clock, looking for someone to go on a trip somewhere with them to pull them out. But that's the sort of respect that we earned at that time there. We put a lot into boxing, make no mistake, we pulled our weight at county board level, at Ulster level, and I suppose for myself the big one would have been to vice president of the Ulster Council, where I replaced a guy called Johnny Black, and Johnny was a big friend of the country fella. And I'm sure Johnny, if he looked down and said, well, I'm glad that bloody Gaul man got there, you know. But of course, meeting Muhammad Ali, and that's pretty well documented in Cincinnati in 93 when I managed an Irish team in America, that was a big one. The World Championships in Belfast in 2001 were colossal. And you will remember, I was captain of Buncrana Golf Club that year. I took over from yourself on it, and only for Francis McGrory and the boys that have made a complete hash of it. But over the years, I've had a lot of good people around me, some great people around me. And, you know, I've Angelo and Tosh at the moment there. Poor old Tosh has been run all over. We're looking after one another big time.
Tosh lost two stone weights last 3 weeks, I was telling
me. I couldn't believe that. I was wondering why his jocks was falling down off him, but that doesn't surprise me. But they have been a huge help to me. But John McGrory,
yep.
Marcellus Shorten, they're the two old stalwarts that keep the whole thing going and keep me right. And we're fortunate that we had a lot of great people on the CE scheme, so they're the people. And we had Anne Toy as administrator way back for 4 years. Anne was brilliant. Adele McGonigal came after that for 3 years. Now we have Kathleen Sarsfield. Mm-hmm. And Kathleen has got a huge insight into boxing and a whole lot of things in Donegal over the last month. But she had long fingers when she came in, now they're down to stumps from typing up the stuff. Gary McLaughlin, big Gary down the golf club, you know Gary well. Yeah. Gary says whatever he does it well. Yeah. He's done a whole lot of stuff for the book, fantastic stuff, and it's earned a huge respect for his skills. And then Bernard McLaughlin out in Swinney Prent. Bernard has done a fabulous job on it. Now, he had good material to work on for a start, but he did the job and he did the work on it, and it turned out a grand book.
That's a great book.
And some of the content of the writing there is absolutely brilliant. Do you know how to describe on that? He was something else.
Whoever wrote that there knew what he was doing, definitely.
Oh, he definitely did. There's Angelo there. Now, he had hair when he was a young fella. Look at the shape of him now. But we're here tonight, we're here to celebrate, we're here to have a nice crack, and that's what we're about. It's not about beating the head of one another, it's about to mark the occasion. Uh-huh. And we will do that, and hopefully people will enjoy it, and the crowd is gathering up. It's early yet, but I think we'll have a fairly decent crowd here. So listen, Cormac, I could go on all night, and I want to thank the public out there over the years.
Uh-huh.
The public over the years have been absolutely brilliant. And only for
and your sponsors as well?
Sponsors are hugely important. Uh-huh. You know, today without the sponsors, and we got a great response to sponsors for the book, as you can see there, like, and at times after the Christmas, not a great time looking for money, but those people have stepped up to the mark and they've done a tremendous job on it, and I thank those people. And I can safely say, going round about talking to them, the biggest problem I had with them was getting out, having a chat about the good old days and what went on and all the rest of it. But here we are tonight anyhow, and you have more people to interview that probably will be more eloquent and probably tell more truths than I will. But it's great to have you, Cormac. Good to see you looking good. You weren't a bad one if you stuck at it. You know, but your face is too pretty.
It was the women break, me, PJ.
It was, yeah, that was a major part of it.
Well, PJ, we know you're going to have a busy night here now, and will you go and do the rest of your duties, because you have to meet a lot of people and greet a lot of people, and you're the man behind the scenes, and fair pity for keeping the show on the road.
Not at all, I've enjoyed it by and large, you know, and thanks very much, Cormac, and I'll get another victim for you in a minute.
No problem, PJ.
Looking around the hall here now, big crowd here tonight. Looking at Q Henderson here now, a former member of Buncrana Boxing Club, along with Jim Cowell. They're still coming on the doors here. They came from all over tonight, from Eagle, Bally Shannon, Derry, Cairn, Omani. All over the Donegal, Andre. We have a great facility here, Buncrana Boys Club. Celebrating 50 years of boxing here. We're looking down there at Mickey Dunne now. Mickey used to do a lot of boxing about Buncrana here. He's a bit shy, so he's now. He's a bit like Mickey Rock. Mickey was shy too. Mickey's covering his grey hairs. His cap. And we're scrolling on across here now. Look down the back of the hall there now. We have a few ex-champions down there somewhere. There's Q Doherty walking down there in the black leather jacket. He's a former Irish champion. Done a lot of boxing here in Buncrana Boys Club. Did a lot of coaching after that then. We have Tosh here in the red corner. And in the blue corner we have Angelo Eagles with his boxer.
Best of three.
is an exhibition bout here, these two young boys from Buncrana. Green or red, McFadden in the blue. An exhibition bout here. Big Jimmy in the middle of the ring. Referee. Two boxers step into the middle of the ring here. We're about to get the show on the road here now with these two young boxers going for a mount contest. First round. Here we go. Summary, good right jab's been thrown there. Left jab to the belly. These two young badgers here throwing nice punches. Last 10 seconds of the third round. Both badgers are throwing plenty of punches. And both badgers are very well. First time around. Pretty good exhibition there. Working on very well.
Show your appreciation for both boxers on the road to this contest. With our 12 boys, the department of three league events, it was.
Here now is another member of Buncrana Boxing Club, Toys Fitzpatrick. Toys is a long member here in the club. He had a good career boxing too in his younger days. I'm not going to tell you how long ago that is, but Toys is going to tell us a few words about his time in Buncrana Boxing Club, boxing and now coaching.
We had some time here years ago. We started off, I think it was 1970, a few of us. Through the years, great time. Some great characters in this club. You had Bernie O'Donnell, you had John Fair, you had Big Brother Connolly, great coach. You had Fonsi Cedra, and a few boys that I grew up with were here and died. God rest him. I know he's in heaven. Young Johnny McDade, great character. But then after that, Buncrana's full of good people. You love by the sword, you fight by the sword. You box for one club and one club only, and that's the way we worked, and that's why we're so successful today. Yep.
How do you find the young boys coming through now, Toys? Are they fit to train the way these boys trained?
No. They wouldn't.
Have the stamina.
Haven't got the stamina at all, Cormac. No, definitely wouldn't, compared to what we had to do. You ask the young boy now, they run from the boys' club, they fall out, he's rocking, they look at you. Have to say, I'm not doing that. But we have a couple of good boys. Young Stephen Boner, Mary's title. We had young Wanish. Young boys like that. They trained hard, and that's where we were successful with them. And then you had your man back years ago, Q. Very good man, won All Ireland and lost their titles. Buncrana put through some great boxers. People don't realise that. Then you have these other clubs jumping on the bandwagon, but sure, we don't care about them. We're Buncrana Boxing Club, and that's it.
These are the first club about here, and these are the best club about here.
Without a doubt, in my eyes. And that'll not change.
That'll not change, Toys. Toys, we know you're going to have a busy night here now because you have a lot of young boys with through your hands here tonight, and we'll let you go and enjoy it now, Toys. So, all the best tonight.
Thank you, Mr. Doherty, very much.
Here we go for the first official bout of the night. Gill in the red and Cook in the blue. First round here. 3 1.5 minute rounds. Both young boxers in the centre of the ring. And some nice punches through there for the first few seconds of the first round, and the two of them throwing nice jabs, both of them looking very sharp here. With Gill in the red and Cook in the blue. The referee's going to tumble one of them, just get out of the road. Both of them looking sharp here. The great end of the third round. Both boxers are out their feet and they're still throwing punches. What an end of the fight. What a scrap. A great scrap there. Great third round for both boxers. Great scrap by both boxers. Right, we're here now with Angelo Eagles here, another coach from Buncrana Boys Club. Angelo, coaching here now his last 9 years, and tell us a bit about your coaching, Angelo.
Well, I'm just, as you said, in here 9 years now, coming 10 years, and with a lot of youngsters up through the years, a few champions. But it's great to see the youngsters training hard, one of the hardest sports in the world, and there are a whole lot of them dedicated. The present time, we have about 26 youngsters there, with 25 last night. and me and Tosh just put them through the paces. It would be great if we had another one or two coaches to help us, because they're not getting the right training, but we just kept doing everybody at the one time.
You're not getting one-on-ones at the minute?
No, not one-on-one, which would be a great help for the office, and I'd pick them on a lot better than doing different groups. So
you like to say a word about your old buddy Johnny McDade, was a good coach here with you too?
Johnny was a great crack. CHL, cool hand look. Mm-hmm. He couldn't get me excited, and anything he done it right. He eventually got there. It might take him an hour, do a half an hour job, but he done it, and he was great. And he's fond of the club, and anything you ask him to do it, no problem. But I tell you, no problem. He says, he's a great young fella. Unbelievable.
Johnny was a great big man. And so we know you're going to be busy now, because you have a lot of young boys here getting ready, and the box is not far away from kicking off. So we're going to let you go and get things sorted out, and good luck tonight on your big ball.
Thanks very much, Cornick. So we're going to rumble in the jungle.
Rumble in the jungle, no bar at all. Good luck. We're here now with Peter O'Donnell, President of the County Board here now. Peter, this is 50 years of Buncrana Boxing Club here now, and I say you've seen some changes over the years with all different clubs, and here in Buncrana as well.
A great club here, Buncrana. It's a great milestone to reach 50 years in amateur boxing, and they have produced some great boxers all down the years. They've always been thereabout. They have a great tradition here in Buncrana, one of the first clubs on about Donegal. And it's a credit to PJ Halloran and everybody that associated with the Buncrana Boxing Club, past and present. It's a great setup here they have, you know, and hopefully they have a big night tonight. They celebrate 50 years.
Hope it goes well, all right. There's bet in the bookies today, Peter. Who's going to talk the longest, PJ or Trump? And I think PJ won it.
Oh, PJ will win by mile, PJ. Because this could go on well into the night with PJ. When PJ gets started, there'll be some bother to get him stopped.
That's for sure. Peter, thanks a million.
No problem.
Good luck tonight, Peter. We're here now with Paddy Doherty here from Ballyshannon, a former Irish champion. Paddy, I would say you've seen some changes in your boxing here all over the years, and I'm sure you know PJ a lifetime too.
I know PJ a lifetime, and I know PJ is 20, 25 years, and it's a credit to PJ for what he's done for this community, you know. He made a great job of it. I hope he keeps going, to be said about it.
It's tough to kill a bad thing, so I'm sure PJ will be around for a long few years yet.
Well, he's a gentleman. Yes. That's PJ is, like, you know. And the thing about PJ, I mean, it's a saying to you, he'd say to your face, he'd not go behind your back, he said, you know.
Sure.
And he's a great man, PJ, you know. And it's a credit to him for what he's done for the community in Buncrana here. And I'm sorry that he's not in Ballyshannon.
Well, we're glad to have him here, Paddy, and just enjoy the night now and enjoy the boxing, Paddy.
Yes, thank you very much, eh?
We're over here, John Fair now. John was a great member of Buncrana Basketball for years. John John started the UFC before UFC was even on the market.
But I know you never fail to answer a question yet. What mileage have you on the clock?
Oh, big mileage.
Big mileage.
Ready for a reconditioned engine.
God, I don't know. You might be, but you're not going to get one, are you?
No.
You're near the big one, aren't you?
I'll be 79 in a week's time.
Well, John, fair play to you. Too many hands, but I'll shake your hand on that one.
I've done a bit of wrestling and played football. And I tried everything. Weightlifting and dairy. Took a whole crowd of Buncrana boys and Seamus Cassidy.
You did.
Logan and... everybody.
You certainly did all that, John. But as well as that, you at the early days of boxing in Buncrana, 66, 67, you boxed in the Plaza.
That's right.
And after that, any place the name John Fair appeared on a bill, you were guaranteed a full house.
Ah, well, they liked the extras. I'd done about 4 years wrestling, and you're able to work on the old stunts. And
you did.
Hitting after the bell. I loved everything like that.
There was a man said one time that the only function the referee served when you were in the ring was to stop you when the bell went. Other than that, it was dangerous to get in between you and whoever it was.
I remember Joe McCallion said one time, me and McCall was at it. I rubbed my nose bleeding on his shirt. he was all worried about the shirt. he actually sent Andy McLinchy a bill.
He did.
For a shirt.
Yes.
And he said, you can fight away to F. And we did fight away.
We had many great nights, John, all over the place.
Great, great.
But do you remember the night when we all went to Dunloe? The night you fought McCall in Dunloe.
Oh, me and Brendan here and Seamus Bradley went into this room, and there's a whole spread on the table now and a big cooker. And was it you made the tea? And we had a good feed then with space to bring out. We enjoyed every minute of it.
I remember that night very, very well, for I was saddled with leaving a guy in Mallon Town that was doing a bit of courting around the town at the time.
That's right.
I got in at 20 minutes past nine. Martin Curran, God rest him, who died a couple of months ago,
that's right,
was SO. And Martin, in fairness, held the fort for me until I got in. And no sleep, mind you, I was in queer shape the time I got to the bed 24 hours later.
Oh, I don't know, you had a dance after it all. If you went to Dunloe, you had it prepared to fight.
And dance.
And dance and anything else.
John, you had many highlights. Any one in particular?
Oh, I had many highlights. I think beating McCall the second time was.
It was. Definitely was the ice.
Because he come looking for me. Me and him at eight. I was in the first round in Dunloe. I was nearly out in the first round.
You were.
I remember when he come running out, he was a southpaw. I never faced a southpaw before. And he hit me an awful left punch up high in the temple. And I went down on my head out through the ropes. Danny me not to sit and chewing. And my dad says, get up to F and keep up your hands. And I got up and what is a wild bit of, I thought I was in a boat. Everything was going up and down. And as he come, I let fly and caught him great right hand. I stabbed him. But then the Sweeney's and all got him G'd up and he come to Ballyliffin. All roads led to Ballyliffin, and everybody seemed to be heading for Ballyliffin.
The truth of it, John, is this. You left his face like a butcher's block the time you were finished with him. There was lumps of skin hanging off him.
I mean, running after him, saying, let's come on, finish it. And I was as done as he was. Well, I enjoyed
it. You enjoyed it, John, and you came back into coaching, and we had some great cheers all over the place. And
some exciting nights.
We had big nights. And
Hugh Clark or Hugh Darby and all them boys.
Mickey Donaghy and Skid and Patrick Grant. John, before we finish up, some of the places we went to, do you remember them?
Kildare, Ardboe, Littlebridge, Garva.
Carrickmore,
some tight.
Belfast.
Some tight boys in
Carrick. Up to Shankill and the Falls and Sandy Row.
That's
and
right.
All those places.
I remember one night, you mean, Stephen Friel and Mickey Donaghy went to fight.
Aye.
And the UDA club.
That's right. But we didn't mind. Where the way?
And I said to Frankie, who's the guy, who's the boy on the white horse? Frankie says, don't talk like that to yourself.